The Lord Jesus is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Almighty God, you have conquered death through your dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ. You have opened to us the gate of everlasting life. Grant us by your grace to set our mind on things above, so that by your continual help our lives may be transformed through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in everlasting glory. Amen. Thank you.
died in 1741 in great poverty in Vienna. He and his music were already forgotten. His body was buried in as cheap a fashion as possible in a small cemetery outside the city walls. His grave and even the cemetery itself have long since disappeared. And for 200 years, only musicologists and historians even knew the name Antonio Vivaldi. And then in 1950, in New York, New York, a recording of Vivaldi's The Four Seasons arrived at the Liberty Music Shop, and a clerk put it on. The shoppers stopped their activities and started to listen, entranced by this captivating music which had laid forgotten on library shelves for 200 years. The Vivaldi Renaissance had begun, and it was to continue until in 1990, a recording of The Four Seasons topped the bestseller lists in London for many months. This particular instrumental piece by Vivaldi has, in short, become the most popular piece of classical music in the world, most recognizable. His most popular works contain something hypnotically fascinating for millions of listeners. 50 years ago, we knew nothing of his life but the barest of outlines. Since the revival of interest in Baroque music in the 20th century, Vivaldi has attracted many admirers. Vivaldi wrote many types of music, instrumental, vocal, and sacred. This evening, the chamber choir sings Vivaldi's Gloria. Although he is best known for his instrumental compositions, his sacred music is at the core and center of his artistic thought. In the future, his sacred music may soon be regarded as the equal of, if not in many respects superior to, the instrumental music for which he's always and rightly been so highly regarded. So in spite of all of our nice attire and fancy clothes this evening, we want you to focus on the spirit of the music, the worship for which it's been intended, not just simply hearing beautiful music or to present a concert, but to worship the God and Savior to whom Vivaldi wrote this Gloria. And you're invited to worship as the chamber chorus presents the Gloria to the praise and honor of God's marvelous grace.
Thank you. Amen.
You'll see in the order of program, we're about to have our closing hymn. During the singing of this hymn, wonderful hymn, Thine Be the Glory, there will be a collection taken for the Deanery of Louth. Louth is a very poor, nearby country to us, and just to help you understand the need of that country, the World Bank recently produced statistics that indicate the people of Laos are 30 times poorer than the people of Singapore, poorer than us. And the people who suffer the most under that grinding poverty are children. And one of the things we do, the Anglican Church there, we administer a hope centre for street children. And sadly, many children in the capital of Vientiane and a nearby village where we work are simply thrown away. And we take those children in. There's a refuge for boys, there's a refuge for girls, there's a drop-in centre, and we administer programs and seminars to help families keep their children, to love them, to play with them and to care for them. So if you care to contribute to that work, your money will go to help them and to help the Hope Centre in the Deanery of Laos. Please stand as we sing hymn number 160, Thine Be the Glory.
Yeah.
Please be seated as I close in prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks that we can rejoice tonight in the glory of the death of Jesus. He died that we might be forgiven. We praise you that we can glory in the resurrection of Jesus. And we echo the words of the Apostle Peter, who met the risen Jesus and reminds us it's all true. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade, kept in heaven for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We've had lots of thank yous, but I'd just like to thank the vergers and the sound people who've done a wonderful job this evening. And over the last few weeks, quite a number of weeks in fact, we need to thank the parents of the children in Christus Cantores, because without the parents, you wouldn't be here, children. But you are here, and we've enjoyed your wonderful music and the support of your families as well. God bless. Thank you for being here.